stop of your visit this morning. Oh, a number of you, welcome. Well, we're so glad you decided to start your day here first. Again, my name's Colleen. What we're gonna do is we'll spend just a couple minutes over here. I'll give a little bit of background, the history of the building, what we'll be talking about when we're inside, and then we'll actually get to go through the governor's house.
You can drink out here, outside.
There we go. Oh, and folks, there's two rooms on either side you can look at, and then we'll gather around on this marble floor here. Come all the way on in, folks. Plenty of room. Two rooms on either side, and then we'll fill around this lovely marble floor here.
Thank you.
Try this photo again, Jack, and look, Jack, can you look up at me? Zadie, look around, turn around. Jack, look up at me. Turn around, look up, Jack, look up, there you go. The cheese. Yeah. He was looking down the whole time.
Thank you.
tired them out. They had to go retire.
I think they're just going back to their place. They're too cold.
So,
that's what I think.
Okay, and eventually, we are going to have a situation where if we're going to put enough heat in this to protect the bricks, okay, so they don't turn into glass on us or anything like that, or they don't break or crack or anything. And we're going to have enough heat in there to have it hot enough to where we can bake. And what I've done, I push the bowls around. What my colleagues and I have done is we put 10 sticks of wood in there. And so we burn them down until they have reached coal status, and we push them around to the edge, because the edge is really what we need to focus on when we're trying to warm it up gradually. And when all of those coals burn down and they turn black, I'm going to scrape them out using my handy dandy scrapey tool here. I don't know the actual...
How does that impact us in the 21st century? Where do you see the language of militia in the 21st century in the United States? It's in the news all the time, the Second Amendment. The Second Amendment says armed citizens being necessary for the protection of a free state, the right of the people to bear arms shall not be infringed. Well-regulated militia, it's the terminology. Why do they call it a militia in the Constitution? Because that's the system that we come out of in the colonial period. We still use that same thought today.
How long would it take to make a bowl?
Or elaborate the ones from up here.
So got three lanterns here, which is from the cheapest to the most expensive. Which one do you think? Three lanterns. This one, and this one.